Blackstone Audio presents Death Will Have Your Eyes, a novel about spies, by James Sallis. This book is read by Johnny Heller. To Adrian and Cliff.
Vera la morte, e avrà I tuoi occhi.
Death will come, and will have your eyes. Cesare Pavese. Chapter 1. The man kept opening his mouth, wanting something from me. But it was a language I didn't know. Not Mandarin, not Thai or Vietnamese, only sounds. His voice rose and fell in pitch, shouting, demanding. I shook my head, the sour, foul smell of my own body washing up over me in waves. Tongue so swollen I could not talk, could not respond. Soon the pain would start again, and I would rise, hover near the ceiling looking down, watching, apart. I woke suddenly, rushing to exchange the currency of dreams for coin I could spend. Morning light fell dazzlingly through the skylight onto the futon. Those wide shadows were not bars or slats in a cage. Only the leaves of plants and hanging baskets up there. That sound was only the phone. Nothing else in the room. No windows. The futon, a painted bamboo screen against one wall, an expanse of blonde wood floor. Tongue and groove I'd put in myself. About as close as the real world gets to the ordered simplicity of Oriental drawings. No one else either. Only Gabrielle and myself. She slept crosswise on the futon, my head cradled in her lap. Trying to get away from the light, I turned over. Oh, yes, please, she said. But obviously the phone was not going to quit ringing, so I snaked along the bed to answer it. Gabriel grabbed me as I went by and held on. I listened for a moment and hung up. Wrong number, I told her. I've got your number, she said, head moving to replace her hand. But I stopped her, wrapping black hair around both my hands and pulling her up into a slow, easy kiss. I'm going for a run, I said. Get the sludge out. Want to come along? It's 6 in the bleeding morning. With Gabby, you never knew what accent you might get. Her features came mostly from an Irish mother and patrician Mexican father, but her extended family was pure goulash. Dad left when she was 3, and she and her mother spent years shuttling from household to household, family to family, country to country. This early morning, the accent was British, a better choice than most, I suppose, for gradations of polite outrage. Okay, but don't say I didn't ask. So go back to sleep now, my little peasant. Pheasant? Peasant. 30 minutes tops, even with a headwind. I'll bring breakfast. And here I thought you were breakfast. Miss, have you considered taking up a hobby? No time for it. That was my point. She shrugged. One stays with what one's good at. Run along now, she said, and was asleep again before I got shorts and shoes on. I stood watching her a moment, her compact brown body against light blue sheets, breasts just a little too heavy, ribcage set high, then went into the bathroom. Turned on the radio there. It was Mozart, a serenade performed on original instruments, which the musicians wrestled valiantly to bring into tune. Thousands upon thousands of dollars, thousands upon thousands of hours, had been expended on this bogus authenticity, these elaborate counterfeits. I washed my face and brushed my teeth, then stood at the window looking out till the piece was over. One doesn't hang up on Mozart. There were a few others in the park that early, a handful of runners and dog walkers, one young mother who looked remarkably like Shirley Temple pushing a pram, another trotting along with 3 children at her heels, all of them androgynous looking, and none over 5 years old. Street people starting off on their day's boundless odyssey. Birds and squirrels worried at yesterday's leavings, perhaps hoping their investigations would help them understand these huge, dangerous beings that lived in their midst. I swung around the park's perimeter in an easy jog, following an asphalt bike path, and stopped at a payphone on the far side, the kind of old-fashioned booth you rarely see anymore. There I dialed a number I still knew all too well. It was picked up on the first ring.
Age has slowed you, perhaps.
As you must realize, I was in no hurry to return this call. At first, I was not even sure that I wanted to respond at all. And after 8 years. Actually, it just slipped over the edge into nine.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.